So now we're discussing a hollow cast iron column. See here, hollow cast iron column, its outside diameter is given as 200 mm and thickness is given as 20 mm. See, this is nothing but outside diameter, that is given as 200 mm, and this thickness is given as separately. How much? 20 mm. This is 20 mm and this is also 20 mm. Then what should be the internal diameter? This is the internal diameter, nothing but 200 minus 20 minus 20, so it comes to be 160 mm. Okay, so this is the, so capital D value is 200 mm and small d value is 160 mm. So outside diameter capital D equal to 200 mm and inside diameter small d equal to 160 mm. Okay, and see, the length of the column is also given in the question. See, capital L is given as 4.5 meters, nothing but 4500 mm. Okay, and effective length, capital L means effective length. How to calculate this effective length? See, here it is given, both the ends are fixed. So when both the ends are fixed, we know the formula, capital L equal to small l by 2, nothing but 4500 by 2. It comes to be 2250 mm. Okay, see, next, calculate the safe load by Rankine-Gordon formula. We know the Rankine-Gordon formula. You know the Rankine-Gordon formula. PR equal to sigma c into a by 1 plus alpha into lambda squared. This is the PR formula. Okay, sigma c, it is already given in the question. How much? Sigma c is given as 550 mega newton per meter square. See, 550 mega newton per meter square or 550 newton per mm square, both are one and the same. Next, A means, you know that area of the column. A means cross sectional area of column. See, as it is a hollow section, we can write pi by 4 into capital D square minus small d square. Okay, and one more thing. See, alpha is also given in the question. Alpha is a Rankine's constant, which is given as 1 by 1600. Next, see, lambda means, we all know that L by R minimum, slenderness ratio, lambda equal to L by R minimum. Okay, see, R minimum formula is already known to us, minimum radius of variation, square root of I by A. Okay, see, I is nothing but moment of inertia, so directly I am writing R minimum equal to square root of, okay, I means for a hollow circular section, okay, I value is pi by 64, moment of inertia pi by 64 into capital D power 4 minus small d power 4 divided by, see, A means nothing but cross sectional area. Cross sectional area value already known to us, pi by 4 into capital D square minus small d square. See, after solving this, we will get, see, pi and pi will get cancelled, 4 ones, 4 16. So 1 by 4 will come outside. Okay. Next, see, this you can write it as d square plus d square into d square minus d square from mathematics. Therefore, this term and this term will get cancelled. Therefore, finally, we will left with only d square plus d square, capital D square plus small d square. Now, see, each and every value is known to us. Therefore, we can substitute each and every value in the formula. Formula PR equal to, okay, see, what is sigma c? Sigma c value is already given. Okay, 550 newton per mm square. therefore 550 into, see A means pi by 4 into capital D square minus small d square, nothing but 200 square minus 160 square divided by 1 plus alpha means 1 by 1600 into, see lambda square, lambda means L by R minimum. See length, effective length is already known to us, how much? 2250 divided by 1 by 4 into square root of capital D square plus small d square, nothing but 200 square plus 160 square. So if you solve this entire numerical, you will get the value as 3510 kilonewton. If you solve this numerical, you will get the value as 3510 kilonewton. But see, in question they have asked us, what is the, calculate the safe load. They have asked us that, calculate the safe load. See, for calculating safe load, they have also given us to use the factor of safety as 4. Therefore, safe load equal to PR by factor of safety. PR is already known to us, 3510 divided by factor of safety is given as 4. And therefore, the safe load is came to be 877 kilonewton.